Your second term exam will be start from 14th December 2020. As you know, this time your exam will not be based on multiple choice question. This time you will get answer sheet from school and the question paper in the form of PDF. And you will write the questions in that answer sheet which will you get from the school. So you will prepare your assignment, home assignment started from 15th home assignment to 25th assignment. This is the syllabus of your second term exam. Student, this time you will write the answer of all the questions. So be sincere with your study. Now we will start a revision and you will prepare all these chapters for your second term exams. Let's start. We will revise our chapter. First, we will revise number system. Generally, a computer system deals with the following number system. Decimal number. In decimal number system, we are using a digit from 0 to 9. The base of decimal number system is 10. Binary number system. This system uses the digit from 0 and 1 only. We will use only two digits, 0 and 1. The base of this system is 2. Octal number system. This system uses the digits from 0 to 7. The base is 8. Next is hexadecimal number system. In the hexadecimal number system, we use the digits from 0 to 15. The base of this hexadecimal number system is 16. Now we will do some questions which are based on hexadecimal number system. First, I will explain you conversion of decimal number to a hexadecimal number system. Suppose we have taken a number 2699. Base is 10, so that this is a decimal number. First, we will make a table. In first row, we will write the, in first column, we will write the values because we are changing hexadecimal, so we will write 16, 16, 16. Then we will write the 2699, the number. And then we will divide the divide this number by 16. 168 will come, quotient 168, and remainder is 11. Then we will divide 168, then quotient will come 10, and remainder will be 8. Then 10 we will write here. So the value of it will start from 10A, 11B, 12C, 13D, 14E, and 15 is F. So that we will write the alphabet value here. 10 for A, 11 for B. Then we will write from B, 8A. This is the number B, 8A. So then it will change into hexadecimal number. The hexadecimal number value is B8A. Now next is hexadecimal to decimal number. When we are changing hexadecimal, first we will write the power of hexadecimal. There are three numbers, 1, 2, 3. So that we will make three columns here and four rows here. First we will write the power value, 16 power 0, 16 power 1, 16 power 2, because they are 3, so that's 16 power. If one more number is here, then we will write 16 power 3. This is the power. Now 16 power 0 value is 1, 16 power 1 value is 16, and 16 power 2 value means 16 multiplied 16 is equal, the value will become 256. This is the value of power. Then we will write the hexadecimal number 7. C and E. Hexadecimal number E value will be 14. C value will be E value is 14, so that we will multiply value multiply hexadecimal number means 14 multiply 1 become 14. Now C value is 10, 11, 12. 12, 12 multiply 16 become 192. So that we will write 192 here. Then 7 multiplied 256 will become like this, 1792. Then we will add all these values. After adding this value, the value will come 1998. Then we will write the base 16 because we have changed this. We will write base 10, not 16, because we have changed it into decimal number. By mistake, I have written 16. It will be the 10. Now next is binary number to hexadecimal number. This is the number. In hexadecimal number, we will make 4 blocks, 4 numbers block. 1, 2, 3, 4. So that 1, 2, 3, 4. Then 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. We will write here then 0, 1, 2, 3. Only 3 numbers. So that we will add 0 from 0 from left side. So it will become 0, 1, 1, 0. These are the binary number. Then we will write the equivalent of this binary number, equivalent hexadecimal number from the table which are given into the book. So that we will write 0111 equivalent to 7, 0011 equivalent to 3, 0110 equivalent to 6. So we will write the value, then we will write 637 and base will be 16. So that this binary number changes into hexadecimal number. Hope you all understood. Now this is the hexadecimal. This is another example. This is the hexadecimal and we will change into binary number. Same way we will write ABC. This is the number ABC. Then we will write the values from the table. The values, hexadecimal digit value is this. Then we will write like this. Value of 10, 11, 12. Then we will write this hexadecimal binary equivalent. 12 binary equivalent is 1100. 1111. 10 equivalent 10 10 10 10 10. So that then we will write the values from left side 10 10 10 11 11 0 0, and base will be 2 because we have changed it into binary number. Now this is the revision of number system. Now we will revise the computer virus. First, the definition of computer virus. A computer virus is a malicious software program loaded onto a user's computer without the user's knowledge and perform malicious actions. Means computer, the user don't know that the computer affected by the computer virus. So the computer virus is a malicious software. It can self-replicate, means it will be by self, inserting itself onto other programs or files, infected them into the process. Now next is, why do people create computer viruses? This is the very big question. Because that virus created by the people. So that why do? First is to take control of a computer and use it for specific tasks. Second, to generate money. Third, to steal sensitive information, credit card numbers, password, personal detail, data, etc. For this, they are creating viruses. To prove a point, to prove it can be done, to prove one's skill or for revenge purpose. Yes, they want to prove that they are skillful peoples, and they want to prove, they want to revenge their enemy so that they can create virus. To cripple a computer or network, this is the way they fight with the authorities. Yes, they want to revenge, to engage the antivirus vendors in job. They want to engage the antivirus job so that they create the viruses. Because when computer get virus, then we want antivirus to remove that virus. So the people create the job for vendors of antivirus so that they are making viruses also. Next is, how can you know that your computer get virus? So that these are the situation by which you can know that your computer affected by the virus. First, your computer slow down. Yes, one of the most common computer virus symptom is slow down the computer crashing. If your system crash suddenly, appears or the infamous blue screen or death. This is blue screen of death, means BSOD. It knows that your system will be crashed. Your system has been crashed. Pop-ups. One of the most annoying computer virus symptom is characterized by unwanted pop-ups open automatically. hard drive malfunctioning means your computer hard drive doing many jobs at one time. In case you have discovered that your hard disk is exhibiting unusually high activity even when you are not using it, consider checking for malware. Fifth, running out of storage space yet. It will decrease your storage space. Computer viruses symptom can be fill your storage space and may eventually cause it to crash. Unwanted programs or messages are coming. Some of the warning signs are Windows shutting up down suddenly without reasons, programs opening or closing automatically, strange windows as you boot. Next is disable security solution. There are some types of malware that are built to disable computer security solution and leave your machine defenseless. Next is sending strange messages automatically. Yes, the first step is to confirm whether the messages were sent from your account. It means your computer has affected by the virus. Unusual network activity. Sometimes you may not to be connected to the internet and you are not running any applications that can connect themselves to the internet. Means you are connecting internet again and again, but you have not given any command to connect the internet, but you are connected to internet by again and again, that it is an unusual network activity. Applications. If you have tried to start applications from the start menu or desktop of your computer and nothing happens, then your computer may be infected. Means you have started any application and you want to do work and you want to open any application, which are, suppose you are typing a letter and you are opening MS Word and that will not respond, it means your computer may be infected by the virus. Error messages. Your computer will know when something is wrong even before you do. That error message is also coming. Advertisement. Ads are common when browsing. However, when you see them when not browsing, this could be a sign of a virus. Means they are coming many advertisement and you have not browsing that type of advertisement. So that it is also the case of computer virus. Hardware and accessory problems. In case you have problems with your computer display, for instance color problems or mixing pixels, this can be an indication of malware in your computer system. Next, sent emails. Viruses can be spread by emails. Therefore, you note that there are emails in your computer outbox that you never sent, or you receive suspicious emails from a friend, they may be infected. So you will not open that type of mails which are coming from the suspicious friends, suspicious peoples, and you unwanted mails, and you don't know that persons which have sent that type of mail, that is the virus in the form of emails. Computer malfunctions. Computer viruses can causes your computer to do all kind of strange things. Mean computer started to do strange things when your computer start to open files on its own, or acts like keys have been clicked, and there are opening many types of software again and again, and keys are clicking again and again. It means your computer doing malfunctioning and your computer infected by the virus. Affected applications. Some viruses are created to affect some application, and as a result your computer may fail to run such application until they are reinstalled. These are the effects which shows, and which by these effects you can know that your computer affected by the computer viruses. Next is blocked from antivirus sites. If your computer has been infected by malicious viruses, your computer may be prevented from accessing antivirus sites. Gibberish dialog boxes. If your computer opens up many dialog boxes on your screen all at once, this can be a sign of malware. Most of the dialogue boxes show gibberish messages that are not easily decoded. Because that type of message, we can't understand what are the messages of this. Slow startup. If your computer suddenly experiences a slow startup, most likely it has become infected. There is the typical time your computer takes before it starts, and you can note when your computer starts slower than usual. Means your computer taking so much time to start up, starting. So it is also the reason for computer virus. Printer issues. If your printer seems to have a mind of its own and randomly prints document, you have not given a command to print that document, but it is a printout coming out again and again. So that this type of issues also created by the computer virus. You could possibly be dealing with a virus. These are the reasons which show that your computer get virus. This is the revision of two chapters. Now you will continue your chapter, which I have started, basic developing skills in QBasic, that you will also prepare for your second term exam. Now you will study hard. Good luck for your second term exam. Thank you.